Look, friends, in today's From Pages to Screen video, I'm going to talk about a classic and the two adaptations of that classic, which is The Age of Innocence by Edith Wharton. The Age of Innocence is a 1920 novel by American author Edith Wharton. It was her eighth novel, was initially serialized in 1920 in four parts in the magazine Pictorial Review. Later that year, it was released as a book by D. Appleton and Company. Wharton wrote the book in her 50s after she was already established as a major author in high demand by publishers. In this book, the story is set in the 1870s in upper-class Gilded Age New York City. Newland Archer, gentleman lawyer and an heir of one of New York City's most illustrious families, happily anticipates his highly desirable marriage to the sheltered and beautiful May Welland. But he finds reasons to doubt his choice of bride after the appearance of Countess Ellen Olenska, May's exotic and beautiful cousin. As Newland's admiration for her grows, so do his doubts about marrying May, a perfect product of old New York society. The match no longer seems the ideal fate he had imagined. The book won the 1921 Pulitzer Prize for fiction, making Wharton the first woman to win the prize. I read this book when I was in my university years, and I read the Turkish edition. This time I read the English edition, as a double read with Marilyn Maya Mendoza. When I reread the book, I realized that I could admire the book much more this time. I initially saw the book, but this book had much more than just a love triangle. The symbolism in the book regarding the two oppositely charactered women was very interesting to read. Also, the writing style of Wharton was very poetic, and I'm glad that I listened to most of this book in audiobook format to notice the beauty of the words. So in general, I gave The Age of Innocence by Edith Wharton an 8 out of 10. The Age of Innocence was adapted into movie three times. The first time was in 1924, and a silent film adaptation was released by Warner Brothers. It was directed by Wesley Ruggles. It starred Beverly Bain as Countess Olenska and Elliot Dexter as Newland Archer. The film is now thought to be lost. The second adaptation is a 1934 American drama film directed by Philip Moller. And the movie starred Iron Dunn, John Bowles and Lionel Atwill. Philip Moller, a prolific director on Broadway, directed only two films in Hollywood. And The Age of Innocence was one of those movies. However, the book was a box office disappointment. And the most famous adaptation is the 1993 film adaptation directed by Martin Scorsese. The screenplay was written by Scorsese and Jay Cox. The movie stars Daniel Day-Lewis, Michelle Pfeiffer, Winona Ryder and Miriam Margolyes, and was released by Columbia Pictures. The movie was released theatrically on October 1993 by Columbia Pictures. It received very positive critical acclaim, winning the Academy Award for Best Costume Design and being nominated for Best Actress in a Supporting Role for Winona Ryder, Best Adapted Screenplay, Best Original Score and Best Art Direction. Miriam Margolyes won the Best Supporting Actress BAFTA in 1994. The film grossed 86 million against a 34 million budget. Scorsese dedicated the film to his father, Luciano Charles Scorsese, who had died the month before the film was released. Luciano and his wife, Catherine, had small camera appearances in the film. In this next section, I will compare the 1934 and 1993 adaptations according to four criteria: faithfulness to the book, casting choices, acting quality, and my IMDb rating. I try to be as objective as I can in the first two criteria, whereas of course I'm much more subjective in the second two. As for faithfulness to the book, I thought 1934 adaptation was a decent one because of the time constraints, and the movie was much shorter than the 1993 version. It touched upon the main event, but sometimes failed to give the details which are very, very significant to the whole story. Whereas 1993 adaptation was almost perfect for a movie. Many of the lines were direct from the book, and also the parts that were edited were not critical in any way. So I gave 1993 adaptation a plus. For casting choices, I gave both of the adaptations a check. In 1934 adaptation, although the main three characters were cast according to how they are described in the book, some of the side characters who were very much important to the story were casted according to that actor's experience instead of the age portrayed in the book. For 1993 adaptation, the main reason was that Mae Welland was described as the fair one, and Countess Alenska was the dark one, and the physical characteristics of the actresses were the exact opposite. I gave 1934 adaptation a check again. I thought especially Iron Dan played very, very well, but because of the abundance of theatrical acting in the movies, some of the scenes were over dramatic, which was not in any sense the atmosphere in the book. But nobody annoyed me, so I gave it a check. 1993 adaptation, I thought everybody who was included in the cast, including very, very small characters, acted superbly. I was very much affected by the emotions that they gave, that they showed, and in some scenes I felt the emotion even more than the scene in the book. So they were perfect, and I gave acting a plus, of course. For my IMDb rating, I gave 1934 adaptation a 6 out of 10. It was a very mediocre movie with limited budget. The 1993 adaptation was much, much better. I gave it an 8 out of 10. Especially I was very much affected by the beautiful cinematography of the movie. I have not watched a movie that is so aesthetically pleasing for a very long time. So like the book, I gave 1993 adaptation an 8 out of 10. As for Turkish word of the day, since divorce was a very important subject in the book and the movie, I thought divorce should be the word of the day. Divorce means boşanmak in Turkish, and boşanmak is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day.